Hi, this is Eddie from Switzerland, and we have another knife review, and today we're looking at the newest release by Petrified Fish Knives. You certainly know the brand. If you follow the channel, there are a bunch of knives from them that I have reviewed, and you can check that out while checking out the links in the description below and also clicking on one of the videos at the end of this one in the end screen. But today we're looking at a very interesting, very large offering from Petrified Fish. And they have done some large and some smaller knives, but this one really, I think, is a very, very cool design. And it's called the Petrified Fish PFB05 Tummy. And it looks like this. As you know from Petrified Fish, usually there are different versions available on each of their knife models when they come out. And it's the same on this one. Here I have the satin bladed version with the kind of white or cream colored G10, also G10 backspace. You see sandwich construction, stainless steel liners. These are 1.5 millimeter thick, and you can see there is some lightning pockets drilled or lightning holes drilled into the stainless steel liners. It is a liner lock. We got a standard kind of Petrified Fish hardware, the decorative pivot, and the smaller body screws. We got this kind of integrated lanyard slot. We got a deep carry, only one side tip up carry, stainless steel kind of bent pocket clip in a kind of slight stone wash that is inset into the G10, but unfortunately uses these kind of button head screws. These should be countersunk, or would be better if they were countersunk, and it actually carries quite nice and deep in the pocket, even for such a large knife. Different versions that are available in terms of looks. There is also a green and I believe brown micarta available on this one, and there are the satin version on the blade, and there's also a black kind of stonewash or a black wash finish available on this knife. I think this is the only one that's available in a G10, and we got the kind of standard nicely done medium traction G10 on both sides here on the tummy. Let's take a look at the specs on this new release from Petrified Fish. We got an overall length of 8.86 inches or 22.5 centimeters with a blade stock of 3.5 millimeters with a little bit of jimping right there, and this nice kind of swetch, as well as a thin fuller running almost the whole length of the blade right there. Broad blade, flat ground blade as well. The steel here is Sandvik's 14C28N, which is the favorite steel that they use, in my opinion, on their affordable line of knives. I love when they come out with some Sandvik steel blades, and they have done it here on the tummy. That's also why I really like this knife so much. Blade length, we're looking at 3.86 inches or 9.8 centimeters. So a nice almost 4-inch blade with an overall length of almost 9 inches. So a very solid and large folder here. On the hand length, we're looking at 5 inches or 12.7 centimeters. And weight-wise, this is also going to weigh a little bit of something. This is going to weigh 172 grams or 6.1 ounces measured on my scale. Price-wise, this is going to be affordable, as most of the knives that Petrified Fish produces, so you're only going to pay $49.99 for this large chunk of 14C28N Sandvik steel and the kind of well-known nice craftsmanship and manufacturing of Petrified Fish. We have ceramic bearings, ceramic detent. We got a nice stainless steel liner lock that engages really well. We get some good access to the liner lock right there. Absolutely no problem. You see the action here is really well done. You can use that fuller for a middle finger flick, but of course the blade is a bit on the heavier side, so you have to kind of find the right spot on the blade, and then it works really well here on the middle finger flick. And you can use that fuller as well to open it slowly and control it with your thumb quite easily, as I have seen right there. And the flipper tab also has some small amount of jimping, sticks up enough, and is very easy to open with a light switch. And you can see very nice action, especially at this price point. And we also have perfectly centered blade right there. Nice and solid lockup, absolutely no issue right there. So a really well-made large folder. If you're into larger folders or you're looking for a larger folder to add to your collection without breaking the bank, to just try it out how this is to carry and use, I think the Tummy here is a great, great option. And ergonomically, this is super, super comfortable. I have a 7.5 sterile glove hand. You can see this forward finger trowel is exactly the right size for my fingers. Very, very comfortable here. You got the guard provided by the flipper tab. And then you have a lot of space here in the back in the kind of choked forward grip. You can even choke back like that. And you still have a lot of space left. There are no real hot spots here on the handle. You got a nice kind of chamfer in the G10 that runs all the way along the knife. Usually I like to see kind of inlaid liners. Here we have the regular kind of sandwich construction, but it still manages to be rather slim judging by its size. So it's not a big issue here for me personally, because a very large and slender knife also feels and looks a bit odd. So I think it's very nicely balanced in terms of all the dimensions of the knife. There is no real kind of forward finger trowel. You can kind of choke up like this, but I personally have never done it. In terms of the markings, you can see PFB05 and 14C28N here on the Ricasso. We have a flat ground blade with a nicely cleared plunge grind right there. On the other side, it's completely sterile. That is something that they do really well at Petrified Fish. Also, they really keep their markings to a minimum here. And that's what they've done really well. In terms of the pocket clip, there is no kind of flat spot beneath that pocket clip, but it's not super aggressive G10, so that shouldn't be a big issue. Look of the pocket clip I actually like. I think it suits the size and style of the knife pretty well. It's pretty unoriginal. It's kind of a standard kind of bent clip, but I like that they haven't skeletonized it down here or made it very slender or made it too long. So I think they did a great kind of basic pocket clip here, and they also rounded it very well here, so there's no kind of sharp area on the pocket clip for scratching things or stuff like that. So overall, a very interesting large folder from Petrified Fish with a good steel that comes in at 59 to 61 HRC claimed by them. So also a good kind of hardness area for this kind of steel, and it's also very corrosion resistant. Just a great knife. This could also be kind of a folding chef's knife a bit with its broad kind of blade shape right there. So a really, really interesting design. Would also love to see kind of a mini Tummy here from them. Maybe that would look pretty cool, like a little bit of a mini pocket rocket style with the fuller, the broad blade and everything. So a mini version could look great as well. Now let's do some size comparisons to give you a better feel of how it looks against some knives you might know or have in your collection. We have the CGRB Pyrite right here, which is going to be smaller, of course. And then we have the CVV Elementum, which is also quite a bit smaller, as you can see right there. So not a big comparison. If we take a look at the thickness here, take a look at that against the button lock Elementum, pretty close. So it's really nicely balanced for its size. It's much, much larger than the Elementum, but thickness wise really, really close. So it's not overly thick, which I certainly like on my folders, to have kind of a reasonable thickness in terms of carry and use. And then some other larger folders in the collection. Here we have the Petrified Fish Hairpin, I think, or something like that. It is the PFP10. This one is in K110 with a stonewashed blade and is unidirectional carbon fiber. Much more rounded handles, or much more contoured handles, still sandwich construction. And here I think the pocket clip is pretty much a part spin. I think that they have done it much better here on the Tummy. But size wise, these are actually quite close. So they came out with some substantial folders in the last couple of months. And then a more expensive knife, but also a larger one from the collection, is the Caledon by Tuya Knives and Skeleton Blade Works. Absolutely gorgeous piece, especially this special handle material that he offers. And this is also a larger folder, and very close actually in size to the tunny. So a really cool full-sized folder for all the guys that like to have these larger folders in the pocket. And for the price of just under $50, we're 14C28 and Sandvik, the great craftsmanship by a Petrified Fish, and just the overall good looking package, the versatile opening mechanisms, the nicely dialed in detent. As you can see, it's a pretty strong detent here, which is always a good thing on a heavier blade, so you're not going to be shaking this out. So really, really well done. And I just like the look, especially of this kind of broad drop point blade, the flat grind and the thin kind of fuller. I think it looks really, really gorgeous. And I hope you think so too. This was my review. If you liked it, please give it a thumbs up. Don't forget to follow me here on YouTube as well as on Instagram at 7ready_knife_reviews. And check out all the links in the description below. And thank you for watching. Have a nice day and goodbye.